It's time for another screencast for our science. In this screencast, we will be looking at wind. So let's sail into the screencast. First, let's look at the movement of air. Wind is the horizontal movement of air from high pressure to low pressure. It is caused by differences in air pressure, and the greater the difference, the faster the wind will move. Differences in air pressure are caused by the uneven heating and cooling of the Earth. As air warms, it rises. As it cools, it falls. Cool, dense air with higher pressure flows underneath warm, less dense air. This forces warm air to rise, moving air, creating wind. A wind vane measures wind direction. It tells you where the wind is coming from. Example, let's say from the north or from the south. A barometer measures air pressure. An anemometer measures wind speed. Local winds generally move short distances and can blow in any direction. Local winds are caused by geographic features that produce temperature differences. These are caused by the unequal heating of Earth's surface within a small area. Remember, it takes more energy to warm up and cool down a body of water than it does to warm up land. With that, let's move into the next part of the screencast. A sea breeze is when high pressure is created over the ocean, which will be cooler air during the day, and low pressure, which will be warmer air over land, due to uneven heating between the two. Air moves from the ocean to the land, creating a sea breeze. So a sea breeze happens during the day because land warms up faster than the water, when air over the land becomes warmer than air over the water. The warm air expands and rises, creating a low pressure area. Cool air blows inland from over the water and moves underneath the warm air, causing a sea breeze. Remember, sea breezes blow from the sea to land. Here is an illustration of a sea breeze. You can see the warm air rising, allowing the cooler air that is more dense to take its place. Here's another illustration of the same concept of a sea breeze. Feel free to hit pause and read up on it. A land breeze is when low pressure occurs over the ocean during the night, and high pressure over land, due to the uneven heating of the Earth's landmass. This causes wind to move from the land to the ocean, creating a land breeze. So a land breeze happens at night. Land cools more quickly than water. Air over the land becomes cooler. And the warmer air that's still sitting over the water expands and rises. Cooler air from land moves beneath it. Land breezes blow from the land to the large body of water. Here's an illustration of a land breeze. You can see the cooler air moving out toward the ocean. Yet another illustration. Feel free to hit pause and read up on this one. There is a prevailing wind pattern on Earth. These are called global winds. Global winds are winds that blow steadily from specific directions over long distances. They are created by the unequal heating of the Earth's surface on a large scale. Near the equator, sun's rays strike Earth directly. Near the poles, sun rays do not strike the Earth's surface directly. So the Earth's surface at the equator is going to absorb more of the sun's energy than by the poles, heating the Earth unequally. Here's an image showing the movement of air. In these, we can see the heating and cooling of the air in the Hadley cells. The Hadley cells move air from the Earth's surface into the atmosphere and circulate back down as it cools. We can also see the direction of the wind at the surface, represented by the red or blue arrows closer to the surface. The Coriolis effect is the movement of air caused by the rotation of Earth. As the wind blows, Earth rotates from west to east, making it seem as if winds are curving. Global winds in the northern hemisphere turn right. Southern hemisphere winds curve toward the left. There are four main types of prevailing winds: polars, easterlies, westerlies, and trade winds. Here's an illustration showing each prevailing wind's location and direction. I would make sure I know these. Polar easterlies are wind belts that extend from the poles to 60 degrees latitude. These are formed when the cold air sinks, moving the air from the poles toward 60 degrees latitude. This brings cold temperatures as well. In polar easterlies, cold air near the poles sinks and flows back towards the lower latitudes, or away from the north or south pole. Mixing of warm and cold air along the polar front has major effects on weather in the United States. In westerlies, wind belts are found between 30 degrees and 60 degrees latitude. They flow toward the poles from west to east, carrying moist air over the United States. Prevailing westerlies occur at mid-latitudes. It's between 30 and 60, as I just said, but that could be north of the equator or south of the equator. The winds will blow toward the poles and are turned toward the east by the Coriolis effect. Winds blow west to east. The prevailing westerlies play a very important role in weather in the United States. Trade winds are winds that blow from 30 degrees almost to the equator. They are called trade winds because of their use by early sailors. Trade winds happen when cold air over horse latitudes, which I'll mention later in this screencast, causes high pressure when it sinks. High pressure causes surface winds to blow toward the equator. Winds that blow toward equator are turned west by the Coriolis effect. Winds are high and they help ships get across the ocean. In the northern hemisphere, they move from the northeast. In the southern hemisphere, they move from the southeast. Doldrums are located along the equator where no winds really blow, because the warm air rising creates an area of low pressure. Doldrums occur near the equator. The sun heats the surface strongly. Warm air rises, creating low pressure. Cool air moves into the area, but is warmed rapidly and rises before it moves very far, and that is why there's little to no wind. It's usually very calm. Horse latitudes occur at about 30 degrees north and south of the equator, where the winds are very weak. Most deserts on Earth are located here because of all the dry air. And the jet stream. Jet streams are narrow belts of high-speed winds that blow in the upper troposphere and lower stratosphere. It separates warm air from cold air and can be used by jets to travel a little bit faster. Of all the weather, I think windy is my least favorite to be outside in. That's it for now. Thanks for watching.